إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أعاذنا الله وإياكم وجميع المسلمين من البدع والضلالات والنار، آمين. All the praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We praise Him, seek His assistance and beseech Him for His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils of our own souls and from the evils of our actions. Indeed, whosoever Allah Most High guides, there is no one that can lead him astray. And whosoever Allah Most High sends astray, there is no one that can guide him. I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone without any partner. And I testify that our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the slave and messenger of Allah. We ask Allah to bestow His choicest salutations, peace and blessings on our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family and companions. O you who believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared, and do not die except in a state of submission to Allah as Muslims. O people, fear your Lord who created you from a single being, and from Him created His spouse, and from the two of them brought forth men and women in abundance. Fear Allah through whom you ask your rights, and keep the family ties, and indeed Allah is ever watchful over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and speak a word that is true and just. Allah will rectify for you your deeds and forgive you your sins, and whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has attained the ultimate success. Indeed, the truest of speech is the speech of Allah Most High, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of affairs are novelties in the religion, and every such novelty is a heresy, a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is misguidance, and every misguidance is in the fire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us and all the Muslims from the innovations, the misguidance, and the fire. Ameen. Ibadallah, nuwasil al-kalam في هذا الأمر المهم الذي تكلمناه أو تكلمنا عنه في الجمعة الماضية، وهو تنزيه المساجد من المحرمات والفتن والمفاسد. أستغفر الله سبحانه وتعالى. We wish to continue inshallah ta'ala with this important matter that we spoke about in our last Jumu'ah. And this is the matter of raising the masajid and purifying it from all that which is haram and all that which constitutes fitan and mafasid and harms for the ummah. We spoke about at-tasawwuq wal-ihtifalat wal-hafalat fi al-masajid. We spoke about having markets and celebrations and commemorations in the masajid, and what it entails of muharramat, of ikhtilat بين الرجال والنساء, between men and women, and of يعني التبرج, the woman displaying their beauty at the masajid when they are supposed to cover it, And the fitan that ensues from that of looking one at the other, men at women and women at men, wa all dan maharim. The sounds severe, ayyuhal ikhwa, that it is occurring at the masjid, but what we want to speak about today is even more severe. What we want to mention today is even more severe than this. And yet it is not the tip of the iceberg. This is something that we find it has increased in the masajid in latter times. It has increased in the masajid due to people following their desires and following their lusts and people following deviated beliefs and methodologies and bringing cultures and traditions into Islam which is contradicting the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibadallah, what we are speaking about is what takes place in the masajid of singing and what takes place in the masajid of playing musical instruments and dancing, subhanallah, to these tunes and to these songs that are being sung in the masajid. We should know, ayyuha al-ikhwa, that inshaad al-shi'ar, that the recitation of poetry as occurred in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and from the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum is not the same as singing songs. It is not the same thing. It does not even have the same rules. In fact, when poetry is written, it differs in its rules from when songs are written. That which is sung as the song and that which is recited as poetry is intrinsically different in the Arabic language. But when we follow our cultures and traditions and the cultures and traditions of others from outside Islam, we mix it up with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we find some trying to justify singing in the masajid with the fact that Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu recited poetry in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the two things are not the same. These two things are not the same. With regards to singing, ayyuha al-ikhwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran how he addresses shaitan alayhi la'natullah. In Surah Al-Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنْ إِسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ, and incite and delude whoever of them you are able to with your voice. Entice them towards misguidance. Entice them towards falsehood. Entice them away from the Quran and the Sunnah with your voice. Al-Imam al-Mufassir Mujahid rahimahullah ta'ala, the great student of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said this is billahwi wal-ghina. He said this is with idle tales and singing. This is with idle tales and singing. What do we find in the masajid today? Idle tales, baseless stories, false fabricated events being related to deviate the people from the haqq along with singing in the masajid. Along with singing. Subhanallah, even when it comes to the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now I'll give us an example. Because I have been asked in the last, after the last khutbah, that we must give evidence. And alhamdulillah, brothers gave evidence that what we're speaking about is happening in the masajid. It is happening in the masajid and you will find it all over social media. But even when they read the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam And they need it from a source that is batil, a source that is false, to propagate an aqidah that is false. Read the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from a source that is false, that contains lies and fabrications and baseless things. Why? To propagate that false aqidah. But they don't just read it, they sing it with the lead singer and the chorus, and the imams that are sitting in a row enjoying it. They are sitting with the singers enjoying this, and sometimes singing along. And look at the false aqaid. Like we said, what Imam al-Mujahid said, bilahwi, with idle tales, with false tales, and with singing, they have combined both. And they sing in the riwayat of al-Barzanji. Those of us who know it, know it. حضر أمه ليلة مولده آسية ومريم ونسوة من الحضيرة القدسية. That on the night of his birth, they came to his mother Asiya and Maryam, and a woman from the righteous gathering of women, the holy woman. Ibadallah, who is Asiya that came to his mother, the mother of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Asiya is the wife of Fir'aun. Asiya is the wife of Fir'aun, the Fir'aun of Musa. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came around 600 years after Nabi Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam. Nabi Isa came around 1600 years, or almost 2000 years after Nabi Musa. So, afwan, it is 1000 years. So our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, yani almost 2000 years after Nabi Musa and Fir'aun. Yet they singing in the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the masjid, in the presence of the imams, that the night that he was born, Asiya came. Asiya presented herself but with the mother of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa Maryam, and Maryam also came. And who is Maryam? The mother of Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. And she also came. And other women from the holy woman, and the holy woman that preceded before. In other words, ayyuhal ikhwa, that the dead, those who are in the barzakh, those who passed away for 1000 years, or 1600 years, almost 2000 years, when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, these women came and they were the midwives for his mother. A'udhu billah, what is this aqidah? So that you may believe that the dead can come and help you, and therefore you can ask the dead. This is the belief that they want to propagate, that the deceased can come from the barzakh and come and help you. And they sing these false tales in the masajid. So Allah says to shaitan, incite them and delude them and misguide them, whoever of them you are able to, with your voice. Mujahid said, rahimahullah, with idle tales and singing. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, he said, every caller, and this is the voice of every caller who calls to falsehood. Anyone who calls to falsehood, then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is referring to them. That they are inciting people and enticing them to falsehood with their voice. And we see the singing is prevalent in the masajid. Singing of these false tales, singing of the burda, singing of these riwayat, promoting shirk, promoting istighatha bil amwat, calling on the dead for help, promoting the seeking of madad from other than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, it is being sung in the masajid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ومن الناس سورة لقمان ومن الناس من يشتري لهو الحديث ليضل عن سبيل الله بغير علم ويتخذها هزوا. That amongst mankind are those who purchase idol tales, who purchase idol tales to misguide from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowledge, and to take the path of Allah ta'ala in jest. That there are from amongst mankind those who purchase idol tales. Some of the ulama, they said, what is meant is that they prefer it. They prefer this idol tales, this lahwa al-hadith, over the haqq, over the kalam of Allah, over the kalam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why do you dilla an sabilillah? They want to deviate people from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said that there is no surah in the Quran except that I know why it was revealed, and there is no ayah in the Quran except that I know regarding what it was revealed. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, Wallahi innahu al-ghina. He said, Wallahi it is singing. He said, Wallahi it is singing. This idol tells that they purchase to deviate people from the path of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He said, Wallahi it is singing. Singing, ayyuha al-ikhwa, is not for the masjid. Singing in itself, some of the ulama, they say, tayyib, if the person has no music, nothing accompanying it, and he is singing, Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, we say this because most of these people, they ascribe to the madhab of Imam Shafi'i. And all of this ummah except the imamah of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Al-ghina lahun makruhun. Man istakthara minhu fahuwa safih. Turaddu shahadatu. He said, singing is lahun makruh. It is a reprehensible or a hated pastime. But when a person has nothing to do, he sings. No, he sings just to enjoy himself. This is not music, is not being mentioned, ayyuha al-ikhwa. This is without music. Singing is lahun makruh. It is a hated, reprehensible pastime. Man istakthara minhu fahuwa safih. Whoever indulges much therein is a fool. This is not my words. This is the words of Imam Shafi'i. This is the ruling of Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala. Let those who make taqleed of Imam Shafi'i make taqleed. Let them make taqleed of Imam Shafi'i. Whoever indulges in much is a fool. To raddu shahadatu, his witness is rejected. His witness is rejected. He is such a fool that if he comes in a case, or he comes to the Islamic court, and we know this is a person, he goes around singing all the time, we don't accept his witness. Such a fool he is. Can you imagine that the imams of masajid are fools like this, whose witness we cannot take, who sings, and subhanAllah, every occasion and every opportunity, songs of batil, songs containing shirk, songs containing misguidance, songs fabricated to propagate the belief in the dead and that they can come and help the living. Subhanallah, this is what we have in the masajid. This is what we have in the masajid, and the masajid must be raised from this. Adina Allahu an turfa. Fi buyutin adina Allahu an turfa. In houses that Allah has commanded to be raised, to be elevated above this falsehood. Above this falsehood. The singing, ayyuha al-ikhwa, without music, Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he says regarding the person who does it, that it is makruh. And when he does it a lot, then he's a fool. Then he's a fool. Subhanallah, the Muslim has the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has the speech of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the greatest of speech, ahsan al-hadith, the best of speech that he can recite and that he can read and that affects the heart and that rectifies the nafs and purifies it and that makes him yearn for Allah and yearn for the Akhirah and yearn for the Jannah. He is able to read this, he is able to recite this in the most beautiful manner, and he chooses to sing songs of baseless tales, idle talk and fabrications. How is he not a fool? How is he not a fool like Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala said? So this, ayya wa ikhwa, is from the things that are rife in the masajid. The singing of songs. The singing of songs, yani in chorus even, that people practice like choirs in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the bass and who is the tenor and who is the baritone, and all of this is practiced in the masajid. Wallahi, just some days ago, some of the brothers, they came and said, Shaykh subhanallah, we went to pray at the masjid. Because Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we go to any masjid and we make salah. We go to any masjid and we make salah. We know the tahrim of praying behind a person who makes shirk. And we don't look at the Muslims and say, you know what, maybe he makes shirk, maybe, no. So we go to any masjid and we pray. However, they went to a masjid and they say, subhanallah, we could barely pray. We could barely pray because in front of the masjid there was 5-6 people with a mic and they are practicing their songs. They are singing in front of the masjid. And people are coming in, making salah, making tahiyatul masjid, people are reading Quran, they are sitting, they are singing over the microphones to hear themselves. Oh, subhanallah, they've become like these boy bands. These boy bands where you get this group of guys and you know they are the singers of this area and that area, and mashallah. Oh, subhanallah. This is the reality that's happening in the masajid. And the people of the masajid, they must speak up against this. Because the house of Allah must be raised from this. How can something which Allah warns us against in the Quran, in more than one ayah, and something which the ulama of tafsir have clarified to us, and the imams of the deen have clarified to us, that this is something hated, reprehensible, how can it be done in the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can the masjid be taken as a place for this to be done and for this activity to take place? A'udhu billah. We must raise the masajid from the likes of these things. This ayyuha al-ikhwa is talking about singing without music. What makes it worse today is that they bring the music into the masjid. They bring the music into the masjid. And subhanallah, some of them, they say in the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had the duf. And the duf is a small hand drum with no jingles. It's not these big drums that they are doing. This big drum is haram, as we'll mention the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But they are bringing the music into the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mizmar al-shayateen, the instruments of the devils, inspired by the shayateen, into the houses of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We have witnessed, ayyuha al-ikhwa ulama, when a phone rings in the masjid, and the ringtone is musical, whether it is made, yani computer, whatever they make it, but it is a musical ringtone. We have witnessed ulama who stopped their lesson and advised the brothers immediately that this is from the plots of shaitan. This is from the plots of shaitan to bring the music into the houses of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that you have a ringtone which plays music and you are Muslim. You must go to the masjid. You must go pray in the masjid and your phone will ring. And the voice of shaitan is raised over the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah protect us and Allah guide us. It is not permitted for a Muslim to have a musical ringtone. It's not permissible. Because you may go into the house of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and the Imam is reading Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen and the song plays from your pocket. The voice of shaitan raised over the voice, over the kalam of Allah, over the speech of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. What about coming to the masajid with instruments, with drums and tambourines and mandolins and all of these things, and making music in the masjid while singing songs containing batil? Subhanallah, this is ashaddu tahrima, this is even more severe in its prohibition. More severe in its prohibition. And this is a major sin. This is a major sin. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, as comes in the hadith of Imam al-Bukhari, which he reported mu'allaqan bi sirati al-jazm. He reported it in a mu'allaq form without a sanad, directly from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an affirmative way. Meaning that this hadith is sahih without a doubt with him. Without a doubt, the hadith is sahih. And the ulama, they have written about it, and they have clarified the era of Ibn Hazm, which the Sufis use in order to say this hadith is not sahih, so we can make music. Ulama responded to it. The era is on the one who says this hadith is da'if. It is in Sahih al-Bukhari, mu'allaqan bi sighati al-jazm. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيَكُونُنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي أَقْوَامٌ يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَ وَالْحَرِيرَ وَالْخَمْرَ وَالْمَعَازِفِ. That he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there will be from my ummah people, there will be from my ummah people that seek to make halal, yastahillun, they seek to make halal al-hira, and al-hira, it is zina, al-hira is zina, and they seek to make it halal. And many of the ulama, they say this in today's time, you'll see prevalent in the form of mut'ah, which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam make haram until yawm al-qiyamah. Temporary marriage. People getting married for a night or two, or for a week, or for as long as I'm visiting. A'udhu billah. And this, and they say this is zina. So there will be people in this ummah that seek to make it halal. Wal-harira, and silken garments. Yani for men to wear silk. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it haram for men to wear silk. Not except if you have a case of, you know, itches or a skin disease or something like this, where there's an exception for you. But generally it is haram for men to wear silk. والخمرة, and they will seek to make halal wine and intoxicants. Whereas we know it is haram by the text of the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma'. والمعازف, and musical instruments. And musical instruments. That they will seek to make it halal. What does the hadith mean? That it is haram. If they will seek to make it halal, and it is accompanied with all these things that we know without a doubt it is haram. Al-hir, zina, is haram. Al-harir, for men it is haram. Al-khamr is haram. Al-ma'azif, and they say, oh no, ma'azif is permissible? No, it is haram. And therefore there will be from the people of this ummah those who will try to make it halal. Meaning that it is not halal. And the proofs from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are many proofs. There are many proofs with regards to the prohibition of musical instruments, listening to it, playing it, and using it. Numerous ahadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the point that the Imams related consensus إجماع. إجماع. لكن الإمام الطبري الإمام القرطبي الإمام صلاح and other than them from the أئمة أبو بكر الآجري who mentioned that there is consensus of the ulama of this ummah that musical instruments is haram. How can it be played in the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today? How can we have imams standing in front of the bands that are playing and singing and throwing money at them? Throwing money, subhanallah. This is a culture I don't know. I never grew up seeing this. This is something new to me. When a band is sitting in the masjid and they are playing music and singing and the imam of the masjid, the mufti and the sayyid and the mawdi, they are all standing there enjoying and throwing the money. A'udhu billah, what is this? This is not from the deen of Islam fi shay. This has nothing to do with our deen. This has nothing to do with our deen. And the masajid must be raised from the likes of this loneliness. You ask that Allah Ta'ala guide us. And Allah Ta'ala keep us firm. And that Allah guides the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to that which Allah loves and that which Allah is pleased with. أقول ما سمعتم وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، ثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أيضا في تحريم المعازف. It is also established from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the prohibition of musical instruments. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went to see his son Ibrahim in the last stages of his life, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took Abdurrahman ibn Auf. And when he came to Ibrahim, he took him on his lap and he cried. So the Sahabi looked at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, attabki wa kunta nahita anil buka. He said, Ya Rasulullah, do you cry? Was you have prohibited us from crying? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I did not lam anha anil buka. I did not prohibit crying. وإنما نهيت صوتين أحمقين فاجرين. He said, I only prohibited two stupid, subhanAllah, أحمقين, stupid. He said, I only prohibited two stupid sinful voices. This is what I prohibited, not buka. Two stupid sinful voices. Because what is that, Ya Rasulullah? That is sawtul ma'azif in the ni'mah. Instruments being played when you are in a state of bounty or bliss from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ghannatu shaytan in the musibah. And that you wail with the voice of shaytan when a calamity befalls you. This is what I prohibited. The sound of instruments. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, two voices or two sounds that are cursed until yawm al-qiyamah. The one is the voice of the sound of instruments. The sound of instruments. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have been prohibited. Or you have been prohibited in two narrations of the hadith reported by Imam Ahmad and also Abu Dawud and others that I have been prohibited from Al-Khamr wal-Maisir wal-Kuba, intoxicants and gambling and Al-Kuba. Sufyan, one of the narrators of the hadith, he says, فَسَأَلْتُ إِبْن Dhumayma, I think this is his name, mentioned one of the narrators who narrated the hadith. He said, I asked him, what is Al-Kuba? We know what is khamr, we know what is maisir. What is al-kuba? He said al-tabl. He said the drum. And we have been prohibited from using the drum. And we know, subhanallah, when we look at the masajid, where they are singing these songs and using these instruments and playing it, that this is their favorite instruments. Drum is their favorite thing. That they beat in the drums and they singing these songs in the houses of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And I end with a statement of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala once again. That those who are true followers of Imam Shafi'i, let them take heed. That he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, خَلَفْتُ بِالْإِرَاقِ أَقْوَامًا مِنَ الزَّنَادِقَةِ أَحْدَثُوا شَيْئًا فِي الْإِسْلَامِ يُسَمُّونَهُ التَّغْبِيرُ يُلْهُونَ بِهِ النَّاسِ عَنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. He said, I left behind in Iraq people from the heretics. People from the heretics, the Zanadiqa. They have introduced something into Islam which they call Tahbir. Tahbir refers to the beating of the drum. The steady rhythm that the beat of the drum, this is Tahbir. Imam Shafi said, this is something done by who? By the Zanadiqa. They introduced it, the heretics introduced it. And what is their purpose? يُلْهَوْنَ بِهِ النَّاسِ عَنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. With it, they preoccupy the people from the Book of Allah. They preoccupy the people from the Book of Allah, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. Those gatherings in the masajid, where the Book of Allah is taught, the halal and the haram is conveyed, the ayat of Allah, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, we are reminded with. This is not present, but the beating of drums and instruments and singing is taking place in the masajid. And if you don't do it, there's something wrong with you. A'udhu billah, the consensus of the ummah is that these things are haram. Instruments, musical instruments, is haram. The only exception is the duf that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam allowed on the time of Eid. And at the wedding festival, and the woman used to play it, not the men. Today it is the men that are in the forefront. You know, subhanallah, doing what the woman used to do in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You ask Allah's protection from His guidance, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us firm upon the haqq, and Allah ta'ala guide us to that which He loves and that which He is pleased with. Allahumma la tada' lana fi jam'ina hadha dhanban illa ghafartah. ولا هم إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا حقا إلا أعليته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا باطلا إلا أزهقته ولا محتسبا إلا وفقته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا أعنتنا على قضائها ويسرت على لنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين وفي العراق وفي لبنان وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصرهم وعجل بنصرهم يا قوي يا عزيز. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. والحمد لله رب العالمين.